All right, y'all, it is part 10.5, whatever. And Kendra's like, what is this? And Lamont's like, where did you get that from? And so she's like, I found them in your jacket. So whose are they? And so he looks at her, he's like, and he looks down, y'all. There's no way of lying about this, Lamont. You're gonna have to say something. Y'all, I'm getting mad. Like, this is my man. Like, you need to fess up and say something. Shit, I'm waiting. Meanwhile, y'all, Aunt Ella's nosy ass is peering around the corner. And he's like, let me explain, Kendra. She's like, yeah, you're gonna have to explain. Whose panties are these? And she's like, no, let me explain. So, I've been under a lot of stress lately. And when I went to the bar the other night, I ran into my high school girlfriend, and you know, one thing led to another. He's like, but look, and she's like, what? I'll never see her. It was just, he said, no, look, I had a couple of drinks, and you know, things led to another. You know, I was actually on my way back here, and she's like, no, I don't want to hear anything else. You need to get out. No, you need to leave. You heard the doctor say it. I can't be under any stress right now. Or you're adding to my stress. And the fact that you tell me that you slept around with some, you need to leave right now. So that's when Aunt Ella came back. She walked back some. And he looks at her. And he's like, are you sure? She's like, yeah, I'm positive. You need to leave. We'll talk about it. But you need to leave right now. So Lamont goes upstairs. He packs him something. And that's when Aunt Ella comes around. She's like, are you okay, baby? He's like, Aunt Ella. She's more sympathetic to Ed Lamont than Kendra. And so, baby, she starts packing. He starts packing. He packed a little bag. He head downstairs. So that's when Aunt Ella, she's like, are you sure this is the right thing to do, baby? To Kendra. That's something that she's like, yes, I'm sure this is the right thing to do. You know, he's my husband, and I don't want him here right now. And that's when Aunt Ella was like, she's like, well, you know, if you didn't have that one boy. And she said, excuse me? She said, well, baby, I'm just saying, you know, you had that one young boy over here, and you know, men every now and then, they're going to sleep up and make a mistake. And that's when Kendra was like, you know what, Aunt Ella, thank you for helping out, but I think it's time for you to leave, too. Aunt Ella was like, all right, then. So Kendra kicked everybody out, child. So they leave. Kendra's upset, y'all. She starts crying. She calls Tiffany. Tiffany's like, you want me to come down there? And she's like, no. I'll be okay. She's upset. She's crying. She's trying to think about what is she going to do. Like, what is she going to do? That's when she gets a notification on her phone from her bank account that her, you know how you get, well, depending on your bank, you can get a notification when your bank account either overdrafts or gets really low. She gets a notification on her bank account that she has an overdraft. And she's like, what the hell? She just checked their balance like a couple of days ago, and there was well over $2,000 in that bank account. So what's going on? She checked it. It's overdraft, y'all, by $2,300. She already know what it is. It's Lamont. She ain't got time for this. She puts her phone down, turns it off, and she goes to bed, y'all. Oh my God, poor Kendra. I feel so bad for her. So Kendra gives it a day or two, and she calls Lamont, and she's like, we need to talk. There's a couple of things that we need to discuss. He's like, all right then, so that's it? I can come home? She's like, no, you can come home to talk. Sorry, y'all. She's like, no, you can come home to talk. So Lamont comes over. Kendra's like, you know what? I thought that moving here would, you know, fix a lot of the problems that we had, but the truth be told is that no matter where you go, the problems that you have just follow you. I've been noticing some things going on now for a couple of weeks now. And he's like, you have? She's like, yeah. Like last night, I got a notification that our savings account was overdrafted by $2,500. And Lamont, he's like, I can explain. You know, I'm back to gambling. I am, but baby, I was winning for the longest. I was winning, and then it just got a streak of bad luck, and then I just started losing. But I promise you, and she's like, Lamont, I've heard this over and over and time. I'm tired. I can't do this anymore. He's like, what are you talking about? But I've come to the realization that no matter where you go, you carry yourself with you, so you're still gonna have those problems. And so he looks at her, he's like, I know, baby, I know I messed up, but I know we can work through this. She said, Lamont, it's not about that. I don't trust you anymore. I don't know how we can start over when I can't even trust you. He's like, I know I messed up. He's like, but look at you. I mean, you had that boy over here. And she's like, I know that. And she's like, I'm not perfect. I get that. But just so you know, and I know you don't want to hear this, he's the one that called it off. And Lamont looks at her kind of weird. And he's like, really? She's like, yeah. And so Lamont was like, well, actually, he texted me and said that, you know, he understands that you're under a lot of stress, so that, you know, I didn't fire him. He quit. And so Kendra's a little shocked by that, because Lamont had told her that he fired Byron, but end up Byron is the one that quit. So child, they're talking about it, and Kendra's like, you know what? I think at this point, I think it's best, you know, so I can get through this pregnancy, and as much as I love you and I don't want to be alone right now, it's best that we separate right now. And Lamont is looking at her like, Kendra, don't you think that's a little drastic? Like you said, you're she said, it's not drastic. Oh, yeah, what is this in my hair? Why didn't y'all tell me I had something in my hair, baby? So Kendra's like, yeah, it is drastic. But me being in a hospital for 2 or 3 days was drastic too, and I don't want to go through that right now. She said, Lamont, you have a problem. I can't help you right now. I can't, not in the state that I'm in. This baby is my priority. So Lamont looks at her and he's like, I messed up. I know I did. So they agree, y'all, to separate. They agree to separate. Lamont ends up moving in with Aunt Ella. Aunt Ella's going around. Aunt Ella's upset, y'all. She does not think that Kendra should have kicked him out. This pulls Kendra into 8 months. Now, we're going to fast forward the story because it is what it is. Kendra ends up spending the next few weeks focusing on her business. All right, you guys. So every now and then, Kendra does see Lamont at the grocery store. They speak, you know, because they talk on the phone every now. Well, at least she answers her phone when he calls. He doesn't call her a lot. His butt been going to the bar, and Lamont looks horrible, y'all. He's been going to the bar and drinking heavily, and he sees Yolanda there, and he's still having sex with her, y'all, because he's like, he doesn't know what to do. Lamont needs help. He has a gambling addiction. He's an alcoholic, and now he's banging his high school. He needs help. He can't see his wife. And yeah, so that's what's happening. And Kendra sees him. She sees that it's a downward spiral. And she knows that she can't help Lamont. The only person who can help Lamont is Lamont at this point. So going towards 9 months, y'all, Kendra is, you know, sitting on the couch. And that's when she feels a wetness. And she looks down and her water has broken. Water has broken. Ain't nobody there. So Kendra drives her own self to the hospital. She starts having contractions. She calls Lamont, of course, and he meets her there. You know, at first he was like, let me go in there and drive you. She said, no, Lamont, you know, I already had my hospital bag ready. I'll just go ahead and drive myself. Child, Kendra's like, I got this. So she's okay, y'all. She drives herself to the hospital, and she's there, and the contractions start coming pretty fast. So she's almost there, y'all, but she's not fully termed, so she's a bit nervous. So they get her into the maternity ward, get her all suited, booted up, and baby, 16 hours of pushing and sweating and cursing, Kendra welcomes a beautiful baby girl that she names Chastity. Oh my God, Chastity. And Tiffany ends up flying in and staying. Tiffany is a accountant, you guys, and she can work wherever. She ends up convincing Kendra. Kendra's the type of person, she tries to do as much as she can by herself. She doesn't want anyone helping her, but Tiffany is not having it. So Tiffany's like, no, I'm gonna come up there and I can stay as long as you need me. So Tiffany ends up flying in when she has the baby, and she's going to stay with her for a while. She's excited, you know, she's happy, and she does allow Lamont to come over and see the baby as much as he won't. But at this point, they are proceeding with getting a divorce, y'all. So we're fast forwarding a couple of weeks now, and like I said, Lamont comes over as much as he can in the beginning, but sooner or later, he starts coming over less often. Okay, he starts coming over now. Before, it was almost every day when the baby was born. Now that Chastity is like 2 or 3 months old, he comes over once a week. Okay, and Kendra's not gonna beg no man to be a man or be a father, okay? It is what it is. So Tiffany decides that she's gonna head to Chicago for a couple of days, but she'll be back. So let's shoot over to Lamont. Like I said, child, Lamont is home, looking a mess. Lamont is in his room. Aunt Ella bursts through the door, y'all. Aunt Ella ain't no Kendra. And she's like, Lamont, baby, there's dinner on here on the stove. He's like, all right, Aunt Ella. He's still calling her Aunt Ella, even though he knows that's his mama. He called her Aunt Ella for like 34 years. He ain't gonna stop now. So she's like, you gonna come on and eat you something? And he looks at her and she looks at him and his eyes are blood red shot, y'all. Well, you need to come on, son, and have you a bite to eat. And also, you got something in the mail here, too. So he's like, all right, then, Aunt Ella. So he closes his laptop. He goes to the kitchen. He has a package, okay? And he opens it up. It's divorce papers. And he's like, oh, shit. And she's like, what is it? Aunt Ella, she's like, what is it, child? I guess the divorce papers. Kendra sent the divorce papers. And Aunt Ella's like, she said, you better not sign those. The church members and I, we've been fasting. We've been praying over y'all marriage. She said, don't sign those papers, baby. We gonna pray over y'all. He looks at her, he said, Aunt Ella, I messed up big time. This is it. She ain't gonna take me back. And so, y'all, that's when he sits down. He reaches over. There's a couple of pens. He grabs a pen and he signs those papers because he knows that's it. He knows that is it. He hasn't seen his baby in a couple of weeks because he's embarrassed and ashamed of what the man he's become, right? Switch over to Kendra. Kendra is making a trip to the grocery store. And she's, you know, turns the corner, and that's when baby Chastity drop one of her toys, y'all. You know these babies, drop her toys. And Kendra's still kind of pushing the cart or the buggy, and she reaches down and gets the toy, and that's when she bumps into someone, and she's like, I am so sorry. Turns around, it's Byron, girl. Byron looking fine and grown. It's only been a couple of months. And he's like, Kendra? And she's like, hey, Byron. And he looks down. He's like, and this is the baby? And she's like, yeah, this is my baby. Her name is Chastity. He's like, oh, she is beautiful. You did good. And so she starts smiling. So how are you and Lamont doing? And she looks at him. She's like, Byron, this is a small town. I'm sure you heard. And Byron looked at her. And he tries to pretend like he didn't hear. And he tried not to look excited about it. But he had heard that Lamont had, you know, Kendra had basically kicked Lamont out. And they were possibly going through a divorce, but he didn't know what stage they were in, right? I'm sorry, Kendra. I'm sorry if I contributed to y'all's, you know, having issues. She's like, Byron, no, that is not what it is. We had issues before we even came here. Well, you're probably busy with your little ones, so, you know, it was good to see you, okay? So he starts to walk off, and that's when Kendra calls him back. She said, Byron, just a second. So he turned around. Like, yeah, what's up? She's like, look, you still have my number? He said, yeah, of course I have your number. Why don't you call or text me in like a couple of more weeks and, you know, we could possibly meet up, you know. Just, you know, just let me know, you know. And he's like, yeah, of course I'll do that. Child, Kendra, the divorce paperwork is not even finalized. The ink is not even dry. You sitting there. No. And she's walking outside. Now, when Kendra first came into the grocery store, it was gray outside and kind of drizzly. And now the sun had came out. So Kendra smiled and looked up at the sky. She was very optimistic now. There was no more gray skies. All right, y'all. That's the finale of this story time. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Take care. Bye.